Let's talk about how to get the most out of your LaserStim emitter. So to begin a treatment, we're going to press the stim button up 6 or 8 times, get close to the skin, turn the laser on, and make contact. Now it's important to note, if you have poor contact or broken contact, you'll see that your green and red light is blinking back and forth. When we have good contact, this switches to a blinking green. If you were to run across an area that was bony, or to accidentally break contact, you'd get an indication here. When we locate an area that needs to be treated, we'll note that the green light will turn to red and we'll hear an audible tone. It's important to scan nice and slowly and to give the equipment time to use the interactive biofeedback to locate the areas that need to be treated. Here we see a demonstration. It's beeped. The indicator light is turned to red. We lift the emitter, set it back down over the exact same spot, and wait for the treatment to conclude. When I notice that this green light is turned back to red again, the treatment will be ended. We'll lift and look for other areas. Here we see an indication the treatment is concluded. Red light is blinking. We lift and continue to scan the area. Once you've covered the area of the patient's complaint or involvement, turn the emitter off and return your LaserStim to zero. There are quite a few advantages in using the MR4 LaserStim as well. In most cases, you're having to rely on a protocol manual to look up how many minutes you should treat for a shoulder condition or a neck. Using the LaserStim allows you to really target your treatments for the specific condition. You may have a patient who comes in who has a really hot shoulder and they've got a lot of trouble. They're going to need more photons in the very beginning. As you begin to treat the patient and they're improving, of course, they're going to need less treatment. The LaserStim allows you to tailor that treatment to exactly what the patient needs at that time on that visit. So you're not in danger of over-treating and you're not going to waste time by over-treating as well. It almost allows you to throw your protocol manuals out insofar as how long you're going to treat a particular condition.